G'day everyone. One of the super cool things with working with dates in the Oracle database is that doing simple date arithmetic functions is not at all difficult to do. Let's do a little example here. I log on to any release of the database before Oracle Database 23 AI, and I'll create a table here with a couple of date columns. So you can see I've got just grabbing a couple of columns from DBA objects, the created date and the last DDL time, just two random date columns with some data. And I put them in my table called T1. Quick describe, and you can see that I've got those two columns there. We're going to do some operations on them. Now, I'll write a simple select statement here. I'm selecting the few columns and the difference between them. Date arithmetic is really easy in the Oracle database. When I subtract one date from another, I get a numeric difference. That numeric difference is the number of days between those two dates. So the whole number is the number of days. And if I get a fractional part, as you can see there, that is the percentage of a day. So if I wanted to convert that entire difference to seconds, I simply had to take that numeric value, including its decimal points, and times it by the number of seconds in a day, which is 86,400. And if I wanted to get a total, the total number of seconds in that delta column there, then that's easy as well. Because it is just a numeric value, I simply do a sum, a conventional sum command to actually get the total number of seconds. Date arithmetic, because the subtraction is just a number, is very easy to do. But as far back as Oracle 9, we introduced the timestamp data type to give you a better granularity in your timestamps down to the fractions of a second, and also the ability to have things like time zones in them. So let's see what happens when we use a timestamp instead of a date. I'll drop the table and I'll recreate it. All I'm doing here is taking those two existing date columns, created and last DDL time, and casting them to become timestamps just to get the new data types. We do a describe there and you can see that we've now got two timestamp columns. This time, when I do a subtraction between two timestamp columns, I don't get a numeric result. I get another new data type which came in back in Oracle 9, which is called an interval data type. And you can see there at the right, the interval when it's presented to us looks like a number of days followed by the breakdown in terms of hours, minutes, in seconds. So it's a bit more descriptive than just getting a number with a decimal point from when we did the date arithmetic. That sounds all well and good, but let's see what happens when I try to redo that operation I did with the two date data types. I'm just going to sum up the difference between those two columns. So I do a sum and, summation, in fact, any form of aggregation is not supported on interval data types. If you have to do this in the current versions of Oracle, this is what you have to do. First of all, I need to convert all these things to numbers. So I do an extract to get the days from the difference between those two timestamps. Then I extract the hours, then I add in the minutes and the seconds. And with each one, as you can see, I'm multiplying by the number of seconds in that particular unit of time. 86,000 seconds in a day, 3,600 seconds in an hour, and so forth. That's pretty cumbersome to actually get this to work. Let me now connect to a Oracle Database 23 AI instance and redo that same demo and see if we've made things a little bit better. I'll create my table T1 just as before, casting those two date columns to become timestamps. Now I'll go in and actually do my same query, get the last DDL time, the created, and do the difference between the two. As you can see, we still get interval data types. But now when I try to do a sum, it just works. Simple as that. In Oracle Database 23 AI, you can now do aggregation functions on the interval data type. All those extract and complexity functions are no longer needed. That's very cool. And because we do have this native aggregation support, even the normal, more extended aggregations, such as analytic window functions, will also work on these interval data types now. Whilst we're talking date and timestamp style functions, here's another cool thing that's come in Oracle Database 23 AI. If I flick over back to my older version of the database, you can see there's a couple of shortcomings in the facilities offered for the date data type. We've always been able to do a round function on a date data type as well as a trunk, but two of the other functions in the same sort of vein, floor and ceiling, don't work. You can see here that floor gives me an error, as does ceiling. Now, in the latest release of the Oracle database, you can do a floor and a seal function on date data types. I'll flick my NLS timestamp here so you can see the time component, and you can see what happens when I do a floor function and a ceiling function. It shows that we round up or we round down as the need suggests. So Oracle Database 23 AI has enhanced the implementation of the existing date and timestamp functionality just to make it easier for us as developers to work with those data types. Enjoy!